Hello, welcome to the session Functions in C. The learning outcome: at the end of this session, the student will be able to implement a C program using the basic concepts of a function. A function is nothing but a block of code which is used to perform a specific task. A small task, it may be average addition like this. It can be written in one program and used by another program without having to rewrite the piece of code. Okay, so we are using this program in different other program also. They can call this program so that it promotes the usability. Functions can be put in the library if the program is called by another program, okay, so that it can be included in the appropriate header file in the beginning of the program and linked to the correct library while compiling it. There are two types of the functions. Function can be divided into two categories, that is, one is a standard function which are already in the C program, and the user defined functions which are defined by the user as per their requirement. So in the standard function or predefined function, or we can also say this is a library functions, these are the functions, they are predefined by C and put into the standard C library like printf, scanf, strcpy. Here, when we need to use that, we have to include that into the appropriate header files. That is, if we want to use printf and scanf, then we can include stdio.h, then some mathematical functions are there, sine, cos and all this. At time you can include maths.h, and when you are using like this strcpy or string compare strcmp, time you have to include string.h. Now in this user function, what will be there? In the user functions, they are written by the programmer or user themselves to carry out the various individual tasks, and that tasks are reusable, and therefore the programmer can use that instead of rewriting that, he can use the same code. Now for that we need to follow some rules, that is, create a function prototype. That means you have to declare that function which you are going to create it. Then after that, for the implementation, you have to define that function somewhere in the program. You can define it at the start or somewhere other place. Then call the function whenever it is needed in the program. Now how that function definition is there? That is the, just we have seen that part is the function definition. Now in this function definition is that actual code where we are writing, which can be going to be used again and again. So this code will be determined that function, what it is doing, when it will be called. So there are also some parts in that particular function definition. That is, a function returns data type. Okay, after completing that function, execution of that function, it will return some data. Okay, so that data type we should know. So that is the return value. Then what is the function name? We have to give some name to the function. Then some list of the parameters which in the parenthesis. Okay, then you are having the statements. That is, what are the additions, if statements are there, or whatever other average statements are there. So that will be called as a function body. Now we'll see one example for this. This is the example, that is we are having function name is calculate, and it is returning the integer type. And here we are having two parameters, number one and number two. And what we are doing in the function, we are calculating the sum of number one and number two, and then that sum we are going to return. So here first we don't know what is the sum, so this is a locally we are using. So here we will declare integer sum. So as I said, that is the above code is function name with the calculate. It is calculating number one and number two with the addition, and we are returning that addition. Now whatever the function calls are there in the main program, they are of two types. Either you can call the function with the whatever the value we are working on, or you can call with the address of that particular value. Now in this method, it will be copy one of the copy of that variable value we are providing to the function, and it will be passed to the function, and any modification of that values will be passed inside the function, and that will not be affect the actual value. And but in this case, that is call by reference, in this method the reference we are giving the actual memory address where we are storing that values. So it will be approaching inside the memory, and then if we are adding or modifying something in that values, then it will be reflecting into the memory. And here of course, as we are showing memory location, it will be affect the actual value. And for this we need the knowledge of pointers and array to handling this call by reference. Now here we will see how the functions are actual having their prototype or a skeleton, we can say this is. So this is the main program. Here we are having some two functions, function one and function two. So arrow, you can see this. So it will be go to the start of that function. Whatever the function will do, that will be calculations or manipulation will be done, and then it will be return the value to the same place where the function one is there. I need some another function. So here function two is called. Here again it will be go to the start of that function where it is declared, defined, and then whatever the inside the statements will run, and after completion of that it will return the value, and it will be reaching to the function two. Now here you can see this the same thing we are having here. That is, when we are having actual values here, we are putting that scan number one and number two. Here we are using asking user to put the numbers number one and number two, and then using that number one and number two, we are calling here function, that is calculation of sum. Then here actual my function calling has happened, so it will move immediately, it will move to the function here, and here it will be having this values. Okay, so this will be replaced, this value one and value two, by number one, num one and num two. Then it will go inside. Here we are having a local variable, that is int sum. So it is declared, and then sum is equal to whatever this value one and value two is there, they will do the addition, and that sum, whatever the 2 plus 3 or whatever the number we have passed, that will be 5, will be returned here to this sum. So this is the flow of the data, how actually the data is flowing in the. Now find out the answer for this. What does the following function print for n is equal to 25? Okay, if I am having n is equal to 25, after running this function, what output will be there? So here void function integer n, the n value is 25 here. So I am calling this function with the 25 number. So n is not 0, then it will be going to print this value. So what will be the output? Just stop the video and try to answer it. There are 4 values it is given. Okay, so this function is returning this value 10011. Okay, so this is the function mainly prints the binary representation in the reverse order. Whatever the number is there, the binary representation of that number is there. 25 divided by 2, there will be 1. Then you are having n by 2, that is 12. 12 divided by 2, that will be 6. We are not having any remainder here. Again 6 divided by 2, that we don't have any remainder. 3, then 3 divided by 2, we are having remainder 1, and 1 divided by 2, again it is remainder 1. So accordingly the value is there by this function. It is a binary representation, as I said, that is in the reverse order. Thank you.